The Seal of Binding is an incredibly important piece of Hollow Knight lore that was only revealed to us in the Grimm Troupe DLC. To many, this thing doesn't seem that important, but if you look to the history of these seals, you will uncover even more of the crazy history of Hallownest. These things played a crucial role in the main plot of Hollow Knight, but now I'm here to tell you, they played an even bigger role without you even knowing about it. Wow, this dude likes to make massive claims. Well, I'm sorry. So like I said, I sort of dropped a bombshell there. Now, how will I back these claims up? That'll be easy, because today, I'll prove that the reason some characters can survive the Void of Mind with their minds still intact is because of the Seal's binding. Alright, so let's start with the basics. In the Howling Cliffs, we get to see a lore tablet close to where we summon the Grimm Troupe, which states, "Higher beings, these words are for you alone. These blasted plains stretch never-ending. There is no world beyond. Those foolish enough to traverse this void must pay the toll and relinquish the precious mine this kingdom grants." The lands outside of Hallownest lack a beacon, so the bugs who traverse these regions cannot have a highly intelligent mind, as the bugs of Hallownest gain their intelligence and sentience from the light of the Pale King. Outside of Hallownest, in these so-called blasted plains, the bugs have no sentience and only the capacity for the most basic of survival instincts. Even bugs that have intelligence adapt to the worlds outside and lose most of their former intelligence and such. For example, let's assume that Tuck and Boone are the same species. Tuck, in Hallownest, despite not being quirrel level smart, can string together quite good sentences and get her point across fairly well. She also has an amount of judgment and emotion that Boone lacks. And the simple reason for this is the difference between the mind granted by Hallownest and the mind stripped by the void between Kingdom and the Blasted Plains. Now, this is the part where we move past the realm of solid facts and instead focus on speculating and guessing the meanings of a few things. Some of these might even wander into the realms of assumptions, but they will all make sense in the end. So, just hold your horses. We'll start with this. Despite it being stated multiple times throughout the game that stepping outside the kingdom will destroy your mind, we have lots of evidence from our little knowledge of Silksong and Hollow Knight that this isn't always the case. And there's some pretty weird stuff connecting all of the events to each other, if you look deep enough. We'll start with Quirrel. Quirrel traveled outside of the kingdom sometime after the Pale King decided to make Monument a dreamer. He explored places outside of the kingdom and spent much time inside of the regions outside of Hallownest that we call the Blasted Plains, and he retained some semblance of himself in Hollow Knight, having only slight memory loss. Now, why is this? He isn't a higher being or magically beaconed, right? And that is right. One of the important things about Quirrel is his relationship with Monument and how she entrusted him with her mask to wear as extra protection for her seal. And wouldn't you know it, this mask prominently features a seal of binding which would protect his mind. Now, if you don't believe that this mask is a seal, let's take a look at the Quirrel comic given to some of Hollow Knight's Kickstarter backers. In the comic, Quirrel wanders the Blasted Plains before coming up to Hallownest, but then something interesting happens. Hornet tries to prevent him from entering the kingdom, but when she strikes him, the seal in his mask activates, protecting Quirrel and pushing Hornet away. This means that the mask most definitely has a seal of binding. Quirrel isn't the only example of this either. We also see the Grimm Troupe enter the kingdom, and yes, they are technically with a higher being, but the Nightmare Heart is in a part of the dream realm instead of in the physical realm. So, the Nightmare Heart's tethered to reality and mind are less powerful than a corporeal higher being, such as the Pale King or even Un. But there is a reason, other than this, that the Grimm Troupe can maintain their mind and travel from kingdom to kingdom so much. You got it? There's a seal of binding in a secret room in Grimm's tent. And the even more interesting thing about the seal of binding is that it's in a room where the puppets slash masks that you see in the Grimm fight are stored. This could mean that the members stay here while traveling, or more likely, that they could wear these masks to maintain some sense of protection due to the seal of binding on these masks during their long journeys. Now we have a bit of an obvious part here. Hornet. Hornet was taken from Hallownest and captured to be sent to Farloom in the upcoming Hollow Knight Silksong. Obviously, to get to Farloom, she traveled between the two kingdoms, meaning she passed through the Void of Mine in between these kingdoms. And this seal of binding is even more obvious than the last few. The giant cage she is enveloped in is a giant seal of binding meant to keep Hornet from escaping so that she can do the cult's bidding. Now, some people may ask how the bugs from the cult do the journey without losing their mind, and I have a few answers. A, if Silksong really is a sequel and all endings are canon, they would have to have immense power to break the seal on the Black Egg Temple and get Hornet out. And if they mess with seals, they likely have their own. Also, these bugs have weird markings on their faces, which could protect them from mental breakdown between the kingdoms. And lastly, and probably the most important of all of these points, the Weavers are going to play an important role in Silksong, and it is all but confirmed that Farloom is their home kingdom. And since the cult is so interested in the Weavers, why wouldn't the Weavers create seals for these bugs to use them to protect their minds? Speaking of the Weavers, they play an important part in this theory. The Weavers are another creature that we see that moved kingdoms and kept their minds. And I believe that this was a clever move by Team Cherry. Because they brought the Weavers to Farloom, it confirms our theories about the Seals of Bindings helping to keep their minds, as the Weavers are the creators of the Seals of Bindings. Team Cherry made it seem like this was an unimportant thing, and just some creature with some importance to Hornet's past in the original game. But this is the most crucial part of the entire theory. It seems like they just ran off to Farloom with no protection or anything. They likely retained their mind in Silksong because they created the seals with their silk. And that's the important thing. If they're in Farloom and they're connected to the Seals of Binding, and all of the other characters are also related to Seals of Binding, the Seals of Binding are how you protect your mind from the outside void. Thank you guys so much for listening to this theory. If you want to support the channel, we now have a Patreon page, so make sure you check that out. Also, please consider subscribing to stay up to date for more Hollow Knight content. I'm Raven Bane. Have a nice day.